Hello and welcome to Holman United Methodist Church Children's Ministry Sunday School Service. This Sunday, it's October 31st, and most people would be celebrating Halloween. However, on this occasion, we'll be celebrating the fall season and specifically the harvest. This week, our lesson will center on God's generosity towards His children. We invite you to watch and learn about God's goodness and His provision towards us.
Hello everyone, it's Debbie, and I'm back again with another lesson for the Holman Children's Church. Today's lesson is going to be about God's generosity. In the book of John, chapter 6, verses 1 to 15, we see Jesus and his disciples having to feed more than 5,000 men and women. Jesus had no food to give them. Jesus asked the disciples to go find food to feed this crowd. And Andrew found a little boy with his lunch. This little boy had 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. That was enough for him, probably. Anyway, the Lord took the food, the lunch, and he blessed it. He gave thanks, which is what we do every time we're getting ready to eat. But it should not be the only time that we say thank you to God for something that he has given us, for something that he has provided. It's not only about the food, it's about anything that God grants us. He's a generous God. Anyway, Jesus took the food and he blessed it. And after blessing it, he gave it to, shared it with the disciples and had them share it with the crowd. Needless to say, everybody got to eat that day. Nobody left hungry. And after they were fed, Jesus asked the disciples to go and gather what was left over. And guess what? They had 12 baskets left over. 12 baskets from 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. Can you imagine that? That is just what happens when God, and in his generousness, he just opens the door for us to receive. He can turn water into wine. That's what Jesus did. He can take 2 fish and 5 loaves and feed more than 5,000 people. And he can do that because of who he is. God, the creator of the universe. And because he wants us to have everything that we need, he is generous to provide. Let me show you something. Oh, I don't know what I did with them. Oh, what did I do with them? Where did they go? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Well, you know what? I can't find them. But I don't know if you've ever seen pumpkin seeds. Have you ever seen what a pumpkin seed looks like? They're tiny. Like, they're so small. I would probably have to put 5 or 6 or 7 of them in my hand so that you could see them. That's how small they are. But from these small seeds, we get the most gigantic vegetable, the pumpkin. And today I wanted to invite a friend so that you could see what she looks like after God was generous with her. Meet Pumquisha. This is my friend Pumquisha, and she was just generous enough to decide to take part of this lesson so that you could see the generosity of God. He made this beautiful pumpkin out of a tiny seed. Can you imagine that? Now, if he did that with this pumpkin, what would he do with us? What would he do with you? What wouldn't he give you? He is so generous, he will give you the desires of your heart. Thank you, Pumquisha. Oh, by the way, check out her makeup. She didn't want to come here without any you know, makeup on, so she asked me to fix her up, so here she is. Oh, she was hiding her little seeds. Look at them. Look at these little pumpkin seeds. This is what she looked like before she became this big, beautiful pumpkin. Now, why am I talking about a pumpkin? Well, because we're in the season of harvest. I know most people celebrate Halloween. We don't. We celebrate harvest. And so Pumquisha, she decided to just help me tell this story. And I'm so glad she dressed up and everything. She's wearing her little costume, but I'm so glad that she decided to participate. Anyway, coming back to the story. The moral is that God is generous. He is generous to a fault. And if we are in need of anything, all we have to do is ask. But we also have to remember that God gives us gifts, whether it be a gift to sing, a gift to draw, a gift to write, any kind of gift that God gives us, a gift to act, whatever gift he gives us, we have to remember that he gave it to us out of his generosity. And that gift that he gave us is not for us to hold on to. It's a gift that we should share time and time again. God loves a cheerful giver. And so if he's generous with us, we need to learn to be generous to others. Bye now.